Hello, good morning all of you. Welcome back to Shirdi Sai Junior College YouTube classes. So yesterday we started alcohol's preparation method by the Grignard reagent. So we completed the reactions of the Grignard reagent with carbonyl compounds. So carbonyl compounds on reaction with aldehydes or ketones that produce alcohols. The formaldehyde on reaction with Grignard reagent produce primary alcohol, and acetaldehyde produce secondary alcohol, ketone produce tertiary alcohols. Okay, so different type of ketones and different type of aldehydes produce different type of alcohols, either primary or secondary or tertiary. So now here. So yesterday we completed these reactions. First, suppose this formaldehyde on reaction with methane magnesium bromide followed by hydrolysis, we will get the primary alcohol, and now acetaldehyde on reaction the same methyl magnesium bromide followed by hydrolysis, H3COOH, the H and here CH3, and now acetone, same, that produce tertiary alcohols. Okay, so these are the products. Now here, this is a nucleophilic addition reaction. This is a nucleophilic addition reaction. Here in this case, what is the nucleophile? That CH3 minus is the nucleophile. CH3 minus is the nucleophile. So here CH3 minus attacks on this positively charged carbon. Partial negative, here partial positive. This CH3 minus attacks in this. CH3 minus attacks in this. So first suppose, rate of reaction R1, rate of reaction R2, rate of reaction R3. Then what is the relation? Here, R1 greater than R2 greater than R3. That means, see, for the first reaction is a fast reaction. First reaction takes place rapidly. That means, here, this one is a highly, reactive towards CH3 minus again. The CH3 minus is the nucleophile. So this formaldehyde is more reactive towards nucleophile attacking, and this ketone is less reactive towards nucleophile attacking. So here, so let us discuss the reactivity of carbonyl compounds. Reactivity of carbonyl compounds in nucleophilic addition reactions. Nucleophilic addition reactions. Carbonyl compounds are involved in nucleophilic addition. So here, among the different type of carbonyl compounds, it means aldehydes, ketones, which are more reactive. So here, so in the reactivity of the carbonyl compounds, first of all, the nucleophile attacks on the positively charged carbon. Okay? Now here, let us take this formaldehyde and acetaldehyde, ketone, acetaldehyde and ketone. So which is more reactive towards nucleophile? Nucleophile means here the negatively charged species. So here, to attack that negatively charged species, that carbonyl compound must have the more magnitude of the positive charge. Okay? The CH3 minus attacks on this positively charged carbon. If this carbon has a more positive charge, then it is more reactive towards attacking of the nucleophile. So generally we are saying in nucleophilic substitution reaction, which nucleophiles are more reactive? The nucleophile which has a more negative charge, more magnitude of the negative charge, that is a more reactive nucleophile. Now in this case, if it is a nucleophile, the CH3 minus nucleophile, then this positively charged carbon, is electrophilic in nature. The positively charged carbon is electrophilic in nature. Of course, all chemical reaction is nothing but interaction between the nucleophile and electrophile. Electrophile means here, or suppose electron deficient or positively charged spaces. Nucleophile means here that negatively charged or electron efficient spaces. So one is a positive pole, one is a negative pole. The primary requirement for the bond formation is nothing but one positive pole and negative pole. So here in this case, if this nucleophile has a more magnitude of the negative charge, there is a more reactive. Now, if this carbon has a more magnitude of the positive charge, there is a more reactive towards attacking of the nucleophile. Okay? So clearly, if this carbon has more positive charge, then CH3- readily attacks on this one. Okay? So that is the main point in deciding the reactivity of the carbonyl compounds. Okay? In carbonyl compounds, if this carbon has more magnitude of the positive charge, then it is a more reactive. Okay? So let us check the magnitude of the positive charge all these carbonyl compounds. Okay? So which carbon has a more magnitude of the positive charge? Now here, the hydrogen, hydrogen. These are not donating, not withdrawing. Now, this CH3 is electron donating. By the electron donating nature of this methyl, the magnitude of the positive charge decreases because this methyl is a donating group and this carbon accepts the electrons. So magnitude of the positive charge decreases. Now here, two methyl groups here, plus side group and plus side group. Plus side group and plus side. Two plus sides. So these two plus side groups are electron donating groups, then magnitude of the positive charge decreases. The magnitude of the positive charge decreases. So here, this carbon has a very less positive charge. This carbon has a very less positive charge. So the nucleophile cannot attack readily with this carbon. But here, comparatively, other two compounds, this carbon has a more positive charge. This carbon has more positive charge. So more reactive. So more reactive. And this carbon has a less positive charge. So less reactive. Less reactive towards nucleophile attacking. Towards nucleophile attacking. That's it. So here only one donating, here two donating. So comparatively with that, this one has a magnitude of the positive charge. So reactivity order like this. Okay? So here main point is the reactivity of the carbonyl compounds based on the magnitude of the positive charge on the carbonyl compound. This is the carbonyl compound. Okay? If there is a more positive charge on the carbonyl compound, more reactive towards nucleophile attack. Okay? If less magnitude of the positive charge, less reactive. So generally donating groups decrease the magnitude of the positive charge, but withdrawing groups increase the magnitude of the positive charge. As suppose. So here, so one is the electronic factor. In reactivity of the carbonyl compounds, one factor is the electronic factor. And generally one that is explained on the basis of the inductive effect or mesomeric effect. Now here another factor is also there, steric factor. First of all, CH3, C double bond O, CH3. Methyl groups are larger groups when compared to the solihide. Hydrogens are smaller in nature. So this nucleophile readily attacks. But here methyl groups are larger, so nucleophile approaching tendency decreases. Okay? So here, based on the two factors, we can explain the reactivity of the carbonyl compounds. One is the electronic factor. What is the electronic factor? So generally, donating groups increase the reactivity. And second factor is the steric factor. Steric hindrance. So with increasing size of the groups, approaching of nucleophile becomes a very difficult. So reactivity decreases. Okay? That's it. So first of all, write down. Reactivity of carbonyl compounds. Okay? Reactivity of carbonyl compounds in nucleophilic addition reactions. reactivity of carbonyl compounds. Reactivity of carbonyl compounds in nucleophilic addition reactions. In nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay, right now. Nucleophile attacks on positively charged carbonyl carbon. So, reactivity of carbonyl compounds in nucleophilic addition reactions is explained on the basis of two factors. See here. One is electronic factor. Second one is steric factor. Electronic factor and steric factor. Okay, right. The presence of electron donating groups. Presence of electron donating groups. Decrease the magnitude of positive charge on carbonyl carbon. Then nucleophile attacking tendency decreases. Nucleophile attacking becomes slow. Okay. So electron donating groups. Hence electron donating groups decrease the reactivity. Hence electron donating groups decrease the reactivity. Whereas electron withdrawing groups increase positive charge on carbonyl carbon. Then nucleophile attacks readily. Comma, reactivity increases. Okay, next slide. With increasing size of the alkyl groups, attacking of nucleophile, becomes very difficult. Attacking of nucleophile becomes very difficult. Okay, so electron donating must decrease the reactivity, and with increasing size, reactivity decreases. So here ketones are less reactive than the aldehydes. Okay, this right.
So here,
reactivity, formaldehyde more reactive, next acetaldehyde more reactive, next CH3CH2C double bond O, next CH3CH3H C double bond O, H. Okay, it is strong Bressan group, reactivity decreases, strong Bressan group, as well as size increases, so reactivity decreases. And next one, first suppose ketone CH3C double bond low, CH3C2H5C double bond low, CH3, and then C2H5C double bond low, C2H5. With increasing size of the alkyl group, here reactivity decreases. Okay? First aldehydes more reactive, next ketones are reactive. That's very, very important. And now here, electron withdrawing group increases reactivity because electron withdrawing groups increase the magnitude of the positive charge. That means here, now suppose CH3 C double bond over H and here fluorine CH2 C double bond over H, which is more reactive. This is the more reactive towards the chloride because here this fluorine is a minus ion. That minus ion groups acting as withdrawing groups. Okay, then here magnitude of the positive charge increases. Whenever this fluorine withdraw electron density from other carbons, then magnitude of the positive charge increases. Okay, so that's why here this carbon compound is a more reactive. And next. Now suppose if this one has a two fluorines, it is further more reactive. And first suppose three fluorines, that is the very most reactive because CF3 is a strong electron withdrawing group. Best. Okay? Now next. CH3C double bond O. CH3. And CF3C double bond O. CH3. And CCl3C double bond O. CH3. So which is strong minus I group? The CH3CH3 already. CF3CH3 withdrawing, donating, CCl3 withdrawing, donating. Which is strong withdrawing? CF3 strong withdrawing. So 2, 3 and 1. With the reactant. Based on just electron withdrawing nature. And next here for suppose. See this one. CH3C double bond O. C double bond O H. And now CH3. C double bond O, CH2 double bond O, H. Now which is more reactive towards nucleophile attack? So here in this case, here magnet of positive charge, here negative charge, here negative, here positive. Then in this case, positive, negative, then positive, negative. Which is more reactive towards nucleophile? This one is the more reactive. Because here, positive, positive repel each other. That's why this carbon compound is the more reactive. Okay, this carbon compound is a more reactive. And similarly, this compound is a highly reactive compound. Double bond O, ketone is a highly reactive than this compound. Okay, because here positive charge, here positive. So repel each other, here also repel each other. So then this one is a highly reactive carbon compound. Okay, that's it. Right. Okay. Okay, some more compounds. Here, CH3, C double bond over H, a fluorine CH to C double bond OH and NO2 CH to C double bond OH. So with the nature increases, here NO2 is strong with the dry group than the fluorine. So that's why that is a more reactive compound. Okay? That's it. And next, another point. Aliphatic aldehydes more reactive. Aliphatic aldehydes more reactive than aromatic aldehydes. Than aromatic aldehydes. Okay. Aliphatic aldehydes are more reactive than aromatic aldehydes. It is due to resonance. It is due to resonance. First, suppose this is the aliphatic aldehyde, and now this is aromatic aldehyde. In case of the aromatic aldehyde, this carbon has a very less magnitude of the positive charge. Now here, due to pi pi conjugation, this phenyl group acting as a donating group. That means here plus M group. It is a plus M group. Now here, this methyl is also donating group, but it is a plus side. Here only inductive effect, here only resonance effect. So resonance is a more dominant, and this is strong donating group than the methyl. So by strong donating nature, here magnitude of the positive charge decreases. So of course here, we can write the resonating structures like this. Then positive charge, pi bond here, this. So by donating, by transferring this pi across, this positive charge is nullified, decreases. Then reactivity decreases. So aliphatic aldehydes are more reactive than the aromatic aldehydes. Okay? So very, very important. And even aromatic aldehydes are more reactive than the ketones. What are the ketones? Ketones are less reactive than the aliphatic aldehydes or aromatic aldehydes. Because both are donating groups, and somewhat there is a steric factor. Okay? That's it. And another example, C double bond OH. Here CH3. C double bond OH. Here OCH3. C double bond OH, here NO. So generally by the presence of the electron with the dry groups, reactivity increases. The plus M group and CH is a plus H and plus I group. So it is a donating group, and here methyl also donating, which is strong donating group. Methoxy group is a strong donating group. So reactivity decreases more. And here with the dry group, increase the reactivity. So 4 more reactive next to 1 and 2 and 3. By the presence of the donating group, reactivity decreases. So here, unsubstituted aldehyde is O-reactive. And here, right, NO2 minus M group, that gives the magnitude of the positive charge. So here, that compound para-nitro-benzaldehyde is O-reactive. Its name is para-nitro-benzaldehyde. Okay? By the presence of the electron with the dry groups, reactivity increases. By the presence of the electron donating groups, reactivity of the carbonyl compounds decreases towards nucleophile attachment. Okay, that's it. Okay, so that is the reactivity of the carbonyl compounds with the nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay, so next. Reactions of RNDX with the acid derivatives. That means here acid derivatives means acid halide, acid anhydride, ester, amide, cyanide. So all these are the acid derivatives. So here again, acid derivatives from reaction with the Grignard raisin produce alcohols. So first of all, acid derivatives of acid halide. Okay, let's mix the acid halide. So first of all, this is CH3. So here ethanoyl chloride, or simply we are saying this one acetyl chloride. Ethanoyl chloride or acetyl chloride. Now this one on reaction with methyl magnesium chloride. Now here this one partial negative, here partial positive charge. So which is the more reactive? So generally the CH3 minus attacks on this one and positive charge comes. So here CH3, this one becomes minus and Cl, here CH3. Okay, it is a tetrahedral reaction intermediate by attacking of the nucleophile. CH3 minus nucleophile attacks on the positive charge of the carbon, so that is the reaction intermediate. Now on acid workup, so there is one further step, that is here leaving of Cl minus, carbon chlorine bond is weaker bond. So leaving of Cl minus, here deformation of the pi bond. So generally C double bond has higher enthalpy of formation, and then Cl minus, of course the Cl minus combines with the MgCl, leaving as MgCl2. Okay, this one combines with the MgCl, this one. Okay, next here the ketone. Here ketone again can react with the Grignard reagent. Already know this one. So CH3, O minus, CH3 and CH3 followed by acid worker. That gives a tertiary outcome. That's it. So here the very important point is acid halide on reaction to two moles of Grignard reagent. One mole of Grignard reagent that produces a ketone, and second mole of Grignard reagent that produces alcohol. So here acid halide, any acid halide, on treating with two moles of Grignard reagent, RMgCl, followed by acid worker, that produces CH3, COH, R. That means two moles of Grignard reagent. For acid halide, two moles of Grignard reagent produce alcohol. Now, again, another acid derivative, that is ester. This one is the ethyl acetate, or you can say this one ethyl ethanoate. Ethyl ethanoate. Now here, this one I'm treating with methyl magnesium chloride. Again here same story. This partial negative, here partial positive. The CH3 minus attacks on this carbon. Okay? Now CH3, O minus, here ethoxy group and CH3. Next step is reformation of pi bond and leaving out this one. So here CH3 double bond, here CH3, and here ETO minus, that ETO minus combines with MgCl. ETO minus combines with MgCl. So Mg is here OED. That's it. So next here, this ketone on further reacts with another mode of Grignard reagent, CH3 minus. So CH3 minus attacks on the carbon, so followed by hydrolysis, you will get the alcohol. CH3, same one. Ketones on further reaction with methyl magnesium bromide and followed by acid workup, you will get the alcohol. So your main point is acid halide consumes two moles of Grignard reagent to produce the alcohol. And ester also consumes two moles of the Grignard reagent to produce alcohol. Okay? It's a very, very important point. Ester also consumes two moles of Grignard reagent, and acid halide consumes two moles of Grignard reagent to produce acid halide. Okay? In this case, first step is Neutrophil attacking on this carbon and leaving out Cl minus, then produce ketone. Ketone on reaction with magnesium chloride. So that reaction is resolved, already we discussed. And in case of the esters, first attacking of the electron reagent, next year leaving out the ethoxyl ion, we will get the ketone. And ketone again on reaction with electron reagent, we will get the alcohol. Okay? Now here, in acid derivatives, here first step is the substitution reaction. So in this case, finally Cl minus replaced by the CH3 minus. The CH3 minus nucleophilic form the nucleophilic reagent. So Cl minus replaced by the CH3 minus. It is a substitution reaction. And here, with the second mole, it is a nucleophilic addition reaction. Generally, ketones are involved in a nucleophilic addition reaction. Ketones are involved in nucleophilic addition reaction. But here in this case, first step is the substitution reaction. And here second step is the addition. This is nucleophilic addition reaction. That one is the nucleophilic addition reaction. Now here, this step is nucleophilic acyl substitution reaction. Nucleophilic acyl substitution reaction, because Cl minus nucleophile replaced by the CH3 minus nucleophile, so it is a substitution. And here, but additionally, it is called a nucleophilic acyl substitution reaction, because here this carbon is an acyl carbon. So on the acyl carbon, substitution takes place, that's why it is a nucleophilic acyl substitution reaction. Okay, and this in the acid derivatives, in the acid halides or esters. Or amides or anhydrides, this carbon is an acyl carbon. Acyl carbon, and that group is an acyl group. So here substitution on the acyl carbon, that's why it is an acyl substitution reaction. Nucleophilic acyl substitution reaction. Okay? In this case, first step is the acyl nucleophilic substitution, and next step is the addition reaction with the nucleophilic addition reaction. Acidic halides, I am dealing with two moles of methyl magnesium chloride that produce alcohol or ester also. Ester on reaction with two moles of quinol reagent produce alcohol. Okay. And next, in case of the carboxylic acids. In case of carboxylic acids. So this carboxylic acid on treating with methyl magnesium chloride. Methyl magnesium chloride. Here in this case, acid-base reaction takes place. So actually here, CH3 minus. CH3 minus means here, it is a conjugate base of which one? CH4. So here, so generally CH4 is not an acid. Of course, you are saying this one is a very weak acid. So conjugate base CH3 minus the strong base, so that removes the acidic proton. So in this case, acid base reaction takes place, that gives RCO minus and CH4 gas. Okay, that is the reaction. Did not react with carboxylic acid, just acid base reaction takes place. So that gives a carboxylate ion and CH4 methane gas. Now in this case, this carboxylate ion on further reaction with methyl magnesium chloride, so generally reaction is not possible. Why? Because here O minus is a strong donating. This O minus decrease the magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon. So here that CH3 minus nucleophile cannot attach on this carbon, because there is a very less magnitude of the positive charge, and that too it is more stabilized by the equivalent resonating structures. ऐसे कार्बोक्सिलेट है अब रिएक्शन विल नॉट रिजन नो रिएक्शन जस्ट कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड आर रिएक्शन विद मैग्नीशियम क्लोराइड जस्ट इट गिव इट प्रोड्यूस अ CH4+ ओके दैट्स बट एसिड हैलाइड्स या देयर नो एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन या देयर नो एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन दैट्स व्हाई हियर रिएक्शन टेक्स प्लेस फर्स्ट इज अ सब्स्टिट्यूशन एंड फॉलोड बाय एडिशन रिएक्शन सो इन दिस केस जस्ट एसिड बेस रिएक्शन नेक्स्ट इन केस ऑफ द एमाइड्स RCW bond O NH2 in case of the amides this hydrogen which is attached to the nitrogen is also acidic in nature so again here acid base reaction takes place so RCW bond O NH minus MgCl plus CH4 here also only acid base reaction takes place with the amides as well as carboxylic acids okay So and here this NH minus is a strong donating group. It is strong plus one group. NH minus the negatively charged group is a strong donating group. Generally we are saying. So this strong donating group decreases the magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon. So here and furtherly no reaction. It will not react because there is no sufficient magnitude of the positive charge to be attacked by the CH3 minus. So that's why carboxylic acids and amides are reaction to methyl magnesium chloride. Just acid base reaction taking place. So these compounds do not produce the alcohol. And next, another carboxylic acid derivative. Acid anhydride. This acid anhydride on treating with methyl magnesium chloride. So in this case, there is no acidic proton. So that carbon CH3 minus nucleophile attacks on the positive charge of carbon. So here O minus and CH3 O C double bond O. And next step is leaving of this carboxylate ion and reformation of the pi bond. The driving force for this step is formation of the C double bond that has a higher enthalpy of formation. So that's why here leaving of the group takes place. And the C double bond O is formed, and this carboxylate ion is stabilized by the results. That's why it is acting as a leaving group in this reaction. Okay, generally leaving group, good leaving group must be stable after leaving out. So now here ketone is produced. Now this ketone on further reaction with methyl magnesium chloride that acts on the carbonyl compound followed by acid workup, so it get the alcohol. That's it. So among the acid derivatives, acid halide, anhydride, and ester. Acid halide, here ester, and anhydride on reaction to Grignard reagent produce alcohol. But carboxylic acids and amides do not produce the alcohol. Just acid base reaction only. Okay. Thanks. So here, in acid derivatives reaction, so first acid halide and reaction one mole of methyl magnesium chloride produces the ketone, and further reaction produces the alcohol followed by hydrolysis, and acid derivatives ester also and reaction methyl magnesium chloride produces ketone, and further reaction produces alcohol. So totally here. From acid halide or from ester to produce alcohol, 2 moles of the Grignard reagent is consumed. So in this case, this reaction is SI nucleophile substitution reaction. Okay, this is also SI nucleophile substitution reaction because RO minus replaced by the CH3 minus, Cl minus replaced by the CH3 minus. Now here. In this case, this reaction is a nucleophilic addition reaction. Nucleophilic addition reaction, and this one also nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, the reaction reaction it is a substitution reaction because unsaturated compound it is also unsaturated compound. It is unsaturated compound, but it is a saturated compound. So in general, we are saying it is addition. So in nucleophilic addition reactions among the all the heads ketones reactivity already just we completed. Now, among the acid derivatives, one is the acid halide, one is the ester, and second anhydride. These are also on reaction with methyl magnesium chloride. RC develop on both. Okay. Then in this case, RCOO minus R, C double bond O minus, replaced by CH3 minus, is nothing but again, acyl nucleophilic substitution pH. Now this one further reaction with Grignard reagent followed by acid workup that produce alcohol. So again it is a nucleophilic addition reaction. So now here, let us discuss the reactivity of these acid derivatives in nucleophilic acyl substitution. It is acyl substitution. So in the first step, the reactivity of the acid halide or ester or anhydrides. Let us discuss. That means here, towards nucleophile, it is also nucleophile. In this case, first step is nucleophile attack. Of course, in nucleophilic addition reaction also, first involves nucleophile attacking. In nucleophilic substitution also, nucleophile attacking. But it is substitution, it is an additional reaction. In substitution, it means in acyl nucleophilic substitution reaction, acid halide, ester, anhydride, which is a more reactive. So here, again, based on the two factors, here one is alkaline factor and the other one is leaving liquid in this case. So generally in case of the nucleophilic addition reactions, reactivity is explained on the basis of the alkaline factor or the steric factor. But in this case, nucleophilic acyl substitution, the reactivity is explained on the basis of the two factors. The alkaline factor as well as the leaving liquid. You get the substitution reaction. So generally, wood-laden groups are easily replaced. Wood-laden groups are easily replaced. So here, reactivity in acyl nucleophilic substitution reaction. Acyl nucleophilic substitution here. So here, acid halide anhydride and this is ester. Okay? Now here, this is a minus I group. That is a minus I group. That minus I group increase the magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon. So that's why it is a more reactive. Of course, due to presence of the lone pair of electrons, it is also acting as a pressure group. But in chlorine, pressure effect is less dominating than the minus I effect. So your minus effect is a more dominant. Okay? Got it? Minus effect is more dominant for the halogen. So that increase the magnitude of the positive charge. So acid halide is more reactive. But in this case, this oxygen plus some effect is dominating. And for this oxygen, plus some effect is dominating. So here, strong plus some effect, there is a very less magnitude of the positive charge. So generally here, this lone pair of electrons transferred into this C double bond O, then magnitude of the positive charge decreases, then reactivity decreases. So strong donating group, very less magnitude of the positive charge. Now OR and OCOR, which is strong donating group? OR is a strong donating group. Why it is a weak donating group? Because this lone pair of electrons are involved in resonance with this C double bond O or with this C double bond O also. So it is a weak donating group. So here, compared to this carbon has a more magnitude of the positive charge. So here, acid has first reactive, and then anhydrides, and then ester. And then the esters, amides are least reactive. Amides are least reactive. Because this NH2 is a strong donating group than the OR. So generally we are saying in plus some effect, NH2 is a strong donating group than the OR. So if it is a strong donating group, if it is a strong donating group, then this carbon has a very less magnitude of the positive charge. Okay, got it? So that is based on the electronic factor. It's a minus effect. That minus effect increases the magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon.
And all these are the plus-ion groups. Plus-ion groups decrease the magnitude of the positive charge. But here, the strong donating group, very less reactive. It is a weak donating group. So compared to other two compounds, it is a more reactive. Now next, that is based on the organic factor. And another one, Cl minus, leaving group. Actually, Cl minus replaced by the other nucleophile. In this case, Cl minus is active as the leaving group. So in this one, what is the leaving group? Carboxylidane is the leaving group. And in this case, RO minus is the leaving group. And in this case, NH2 minus is the leaving group. In nuclear weight substitution reaction. So here, so generally which one is the higher leaving ability? So we are saying in nuclear weight substitution reaction, weak bases are the good leaving groups. Weak bases are the good leaving groups. So which is the weak base? Actually, it is a conjugate base of HCl. It is a conjugate base of carboxylic acid. It is a conjugate base of alcohol. It is a conjugate base of NaCl. So which is the stronger acid? So HCl is the stronger acid. Which is the weaker acid? NaCl is the weaker acid. So acidic reaction, HCl first and acidic carboxylic acid, alcohol and amine. So it is conjugate base the weak base. So weak base are the good base. That means here this Cl is easily replaced by the other nucleophile. This is nothing but this reaction. And now here, next between these three, it is carboxylate ion and alkoxyl ion and NH2 minus. Here acetic acid is a stronger acid. So conjugate base, weaker base. That means it is easily replaced by the other nucleophile. Okay? So leaving ability. Leaving group ability. Cl minus. OCOR and greater than RO minus and greater than NH. Okay, so finally among the acid derivatives, acid halides are more reactive, next anhydrides and then esters and least reactive amides. Okay, so acid halides some reaction with Krieghoff reaction produce alcohol and anhydride on reaction with Krieghoff reaction produce alcohol, ester on reaction with Krieghoff reaction produce alcohol but not amides. Amides with amides just acid base reaction takes place. Of course here there is less reactive in nucleophilic attacking because there is a magnitude of the there is a very less magnitude of the positive charge because NH2 is a strong donating. Okay, it's a very very important. Acid halides are more reactive than the anhydrides and then esters and least amides. It is nucleophilic substitution here. And acyl compound. Okay. And one more point is towards nucleophile. Reactivity with the carbonyl compounds also. Acid derivatives as well as carbonyl compounds. Among the carbonyl compounds, all the heads are more reactive. In acid derivatives, acid halides are more reactive. But here, when compared to when comparison between the acid derivatives as well as carbonyl compounds, then acid halides are more reactive than the carbonyl compounds. And carbonyl compounds are more reactive than the anhydride. Because the Cl is a minus sign. That minus sign group increase the magnitude of the positive charge, then R minus nucleophile readily attacks. Now in this case, their hydride is not minus sign, not plus sign. But if alkyl group is the donating group, just plus sign. So plus sign group is the electron donating group that decrease the magnitude of the positive charge. So then nucleophile R minus attacking tendency decreases. Okay? The plus sign. And this one is a plus sign. So very less reactive. And this one also less than reactivity decreases. And this one less than reactivity decreases. So comparing all these compounds already we discussed. So that is the final reactive products. So remember this one, very very important. First the acidic halides, all the aldehydes, ketones, anhydrides, esters, and amines. Okay. Reaction of RMDX with cyanides. So here, the very very important this one, alkyl cyanide and reaction with methyl magnesium chloride. So in this case, there is a partial negative charge, there is a partial positive charge because nitrogen is the more electronegative. Now from Grignard reagent, the CH3- nucleophile attacks on this positive charged carbon. So CH3 double bond, N minus, this nitrogen gains electron. This N minus is neutralized by the MgCl. That's it. So now in this case, if further mole of methyl magnesium chloride is used, it is not attacked by that Grignard reagent. Why? Because here for the attacking of this CH3-, this pi electrons must be transferred to the nitrogen. But here the transfer of this pi electrons towards nitrogen is not possible because already that nitrogen has a negative charge. So transfer of pi electrons is not possible. Then this carbon carries no positive charge. So CH3- attacking is not possible. So just here only one mole of the Grignard reagent is concerned. But with the acid derivatives, 2 moles. That means acid halide consume 2 moles, anhydride consume 2 moles, ester consume 2 moles. Because in this case, C double bond O, Cl, OR, OCOR. When CH3's MgCl attack on the carbon, so minus Cl, CH3. Cl, OR and OC double bond O. In this case, these are acting as a leaving groups. By the leaving of those groups, you will get the C double bond O. That means ketone. We will get the ketone. Okay. Now this ketone further attacked by the Grignard reagent. Positive charge and partial negative and partial positive. So followed by hydrolysis. We will get the alcohol. So here first one more first here it is attacked by CH3-, then leaving of this Cl- or RO- or carboxylate ion, we will get the ketone. Again ketone can be attacked by the Grignard reagent. So these two reactions can sequentially take place. So finally we will get the alcohol. But in case of the cyanide, right, the second mole of the Grignard reagent attacking is not possible because already there is a negative charge. So these pi electrons cannot be transferred to this nitrogen, and furtherly this nitrogen also cannot be, cannot form the bond with this CH3-. So here on this carbon no more positive charge, so there is no bond formation between these two carbons. Okay. So actually it is a negative charge, it is a positive charge. The primary requirement for the bond formation is a positive pole and negative pole. So here that dipole or nitrogen is not possible in this case. So further it is not attacked by the Grignard reagent. So here, that ultimately must be, this compound must be hydrolyzed. So on the hydrolysis, we will get the RCH3 and double. Okay. This hydrolysis mechanism I will not discuss here. So just here, breaking down this bond, H and, so separately you will write this. Okay, with Grignard reagent, no reaction. So that's why that needs hydrolysis NMgCl. So this one on hydrolysis, breaking down this bond, oxygen, hydrogen, So RCH3 double bond O plus this one NH2 MgCl. Of course, it is a side product, it is not necessary. So finally, ketone is the only product. The reaction stopped at the ketone. Because that reaction, ground reagent reactions are completed with hydroxyl. But with acid derivatives such as acid chloride, ester, or anhydride, first addition, then leaving out the leaving group, you get the ketone, and then second step addition changes. And finally, hydrolysis. But in this case, second step is the hydrolysis. With the hydrolysis, the ground reagent reactions are completed. And in the complete event, actually, you want to add to unreacted methyl magnesium bromide amine undergo. The CH3 minus remove the proton from the H plus produce methane. That means here, the first step of unreacted methyl magnesium bromide amine undergo that react with water. What we are adding for the hydrolysis of this intermediate. So our water will come out of CH4 will convert it. So there is no more Vignard reagent in the solution mixture. So that's why the reaction stop at the ketone. So alkyl cyanide on reaction with the Vignard reagent produce ketone. It's very very important. Okay? Further, the second mole to attack carbon. But the acid derivatives for second mole to attack over. But cyanide is second mole of the Vignard reagent, no reaction. So that's why hydrolysis. That must be hydrolyzed. So you get the ketone. Here hydrolysis can make that then. Unreacted methyl magnesium chloride ion taken, that is also converted to CH2. Okay, that's it. Okay, so finally, acid chloride, ester, anhydride consume two moles to produce alcohol. Carboxylic acid, only just acid base reaction, amides, just acid base reaction with this hydrogens. And cyanide produce a ketone. Consume only one mole of the ketone. So one mole of the Vignard reagent. Now, this polyfunctional compound contains ketone function group, ester function group, carboxylic acid, and alcohol. So, for the completion of reaction, how many moles of Vignard reagent is consumed? So, x moles of the Vignard reagent. So, here by observe the structure of the product. So here 1 mole of the Vignard reagent, here 2 moles of the Vignard reagent, so ester consumes 2 moles, that means here 1 CH3 from the methyl magnesium chloride, ketone consumes 1 mole. So here 3 moles, but actually answer is 5 moles. Here this carboxylic acid consumes 1 mole and this alcohol, hydrogen also consumes 1 mole because there is an acidic in nature. So this H plus combines with CHC minus. So further 2 moles of the Vignard reagent is consumed. So totally 5 moles. But here there is COOH, here there is COH. Here OH, here OH. That means your structure is not changed for these two functions. But internally 2 moles of the Vignard reagent is consumed. How internally 2 moles of the Vignard reagent is consumed? So in first year, write the acid base reaction. Double bond O, here ester, after acid base reaction, this one becomes a CO minus, and this one becomes a O minus, because CH3 minus remove the H plus, so these are the conjugate bases, and next step is CH3 MgC, here one mole is consumed by the ketone, and two moles consumed by the ester, so product is CH3 O minus, okay, by transfer of electrons, and next CH3 and CH3, this one O minus, and here O minus C double bond O minus. Now this one on hydrolysis, this one on hydrolysis, and finally on hydrolysis chester, they cannot raise the reaction. So hydrolysis chester, this O minus becomes a OH, this O minus becomes a OH. And now this O minus becomes a OH. This CO minus becomes a COH. So that's why two acid base reactions. Next, three moles are involved in addition reactions and substitution reactions. Okay. So again, product will ask that here OH is there, here OH is there. And E function could be structure change. because thus inverted acid base reaction. What if ketone function will change anything? Ester function will also change. Okay, so that is the point. And the first involved the acid base reaction involved the, but in the final hydroxylation again that gets the protonation. So that's it. So for ester 2 moles, ketone 1 mole, 1 mole, 1. So totally 5 moles of the Greek bond region is considered for this compound. Okay. That's it. So now another example, ketone and here acid halide. This one I'm treating with methyl magnesium chloride. First suppose 1 equivalent of the methyl magnesium chloride. So with 1 equivalent, actually here this one consumes totally 3 moles of methyl magnesium chloride, because as for acid halide 2 moles, for ketone 1 mole. So here OH, CH3 and CH3, this one becomes a OH and CH3 with 1 equivalent of the methyl magnesium chloride, which is initially attacked by the Grignard reaction. So one is the ketone, one is the acid halide. Between these two, which is more reactive? Acid halide is more reactive. So 1 equivalent, just here Cl minus replaced by CH3 minus. So product is, that's it. Diketone is the product. Okay? So diketone is the product with 1 equivalent. So based on the reactive, acid halides are more reactive than the ketones. Let's say first acid halide is attacked by CH3 minus. Okay? That is the minus I group. That minus I group increase the magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon. So readily attacked by the CH3 minus group. That's it.